Water is with us wherever we go. And we use it for whatever we do. From brushing the teeth in the morning, to washing the hands throughout the day, and taking a shower or a bath before we go back to sleep at night. We use water for cooking, for washing the dishes, the clothes, and on countless other occasions. As you already saw in the previous episode, all our major internal organs and fluids are made up of water. Not only this, but water carries all over the body and inside every single cell the oxygen needed to survive, the minerals and nutrients from the food and drinks we consume, it removes the waste products, and much more. All these are possible due to a unique property. The water molecule has the highest capacity to combine with other chemical elements than any other molecule. Everywhere it goes, through the air, the ground, and inside every single living organism, water carries around valuable chemicals, minerals, and nutrients, without which, life as we know it would not exist. Because of this, water is known as the universal solvent, and that's why all first aid advice recommends rinsing the affected area with water for about 20 minutes when coming in contact with hazardous chemicals. Yet, water not only washes away the impurities. As the term universal solvent implies, it also carries harmful microplastics, GMOs, pesticides, and countless other pollutants. In 2017, an international team of scientists completed a major study that sent shockwaves around the globe. After examining 185 studies involving over 42,000 healthy men, scientists found that between 1973 and 2011, the sperm levels among men in Western countries have dropped by over 50%. Following current projections, sperm counts of the average man are set to reach zero in 2045, and the modern world is on pace to become an infertile one. The results were confirmed by another study, according to which, worldwide, between 1980 and 2015, it was recorded an overall 57% diminution in sperm concentration. Scientists believe that the reason for this spermageddon, as it was dubbed by the news agencies, is the growing exposure to endocrine-disrupting chemicals found in everything from plastic bottles, plastic bags, plastic cups, food containers, and food packaging, to personal care products and cosmetics. Most of the plastic we use accumulates in landfills or the natural environment. Blown by the wind and washed by the rain, plastic ends up in rivers, lakes, seas, and oceans. And because the universal solvent travels all over the world, the same are the microplastics and countless many other pollutants, and they end up, eventually, in the human body, mainly through the diet. One of the most widespread harmful industrial chemicals is bisphenol A, which has been used since the 1960s as the base compound in the production of polycarbonate and other plastics. BPA was classified by the European Union as an endocrine disruptor because it disturbs the body's hormonal balance and is associated with health effects like cancer, reproductive system harm, obesity, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, and behavioral problems in children. In many studies, researchers found measurable levels of BPA in the population tested. In 2004, more than 93% of the subjects had BPA in their bodies at levels that were well within the range found to cause health problems, while in 2018, scientists found measurable levels of BPA in the urine of 86% of the teenagers tested. Or, as another example, a study conducted in 2019 found that, contrary to what the manufacturers have been saying, the UV-blocking chemicals found in sunscreen lotions are absorbed into the bloodstream. Blood tests showed that oxybenzone, recently banned by Hawaii, Key West, and the Pacific nation of Palau because it causes coral bleaching and is dangerous to marine ecosystems, exceeded the FDA's limits in only 2 hours. Actually, here's a simple experiment that you can do at home. If you take a clove of fresh garlic, slice it in half, and rub it on the bottom of your foot, you will taste garlic in your mouth about 15 minutes later. That's because the chemicals from garlic are carried by the blood throughout your body, reaching eventually the taste buds from your mouth. Besides being the universal solvent, water has many other unique properties, without which, life as we know it would not exist.